నేను మాత్రం మా ఇద్దరు పిల్లల్ని క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందించే ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీ స్కూల్లో మాత్రమే చదివిస్తాను. ఇలా అన్ని ఉన్న చోట మన పిల్లల్ని చదివిస్తేనే వాళ్ళకి మంచి భవిష్యత్తు ఉంటుంది.
నాకు అన్ని నెంబర్ 1 ఏ కావాలి. అందుకే నా పెద్ద మనవరాల్ని అన్ని వసతులతో క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అందిస్తున్న స్కూల్లోనే జాయిన్ చేశాను.
ఏ స్కూల్ సార్ అది?
ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరీ స్కూల్. క్వాలిటీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లో నెంబర్ 1, కల్చరల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ లో నెంబర్ 1, స్పోర్ట్స్ లో నెంబర్ 1, క్యాంపస్ లో నెంబర్ 1.
అది
మీ పిల్లల బంగారు భవిష్యత్తుకు మాది బాధ్యత.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ స్టూడెంట్స్, దిస్ ఇస్ అర్నమీస్. వి ఆర్ కంటిన్యూయింగ్ అవర్ కార్బన్ ఇస్కాన్ కాంపౌండ్స్ లెసన్. స్టూడెంట్స్, టుడే డైలీ వి ఆర్ రివైజింగ్. దిస్ ఇస్ వి ఆర్ ఇన్ ద స్టేజ్ ఆఫ్ రివిజన్ స్టేజ్. టుడే ఐ యామ్ స్టార్టింగ్ విత్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద బిగినింగ్ క్లాస్. స్టూడెంట్స్, ఫస్ట్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద వాలెన్సీ ఆఫ్ కార్బన్? వై మీన్స్ వి ఆర్ ఆన్సర్ ద half marks or 1 marks or 2 marks in exact word answers. There is no the truth the correct. That's right. Now you try to answer. And my warm request for you students, today class, whatever you are watching, along with notes and pen, please read it. Okay. Come with. What is the valency of carbon? Yeah, 4. Which period it is? Second period. Which group? 14th group. It is metal or non-metal? Non-metal. Okay. Carbon undergoes how many types of hybridizations? 3. sp3, sp2, sp. Will you give an example for sp hybridization? Yeah, ethyl is the example for that exact word you have to read. And in ethyl, how many pi bonds? Yeah, 2 pi bonds. Okay, will you say which allotropic form of carbon used as a lubricant? Graphite. Okay, so which, what is the catenation? Will you give the example of catenation? Yeah, polymers. Polymers undergo the property of catenation. So, what is the definition of allotropy? Same physical properties but different in chemical properties. Allotropy, will you give the examples of amorphous form of carbon? Amorphous allotropic form of carbon. Coal, charcoal, these are the amorphous forms of carbon. Why carbon we call as the versatile nature? According to its forming number of compounds, number of bonds and the property of catenation, it is very important question students. Why the carbon undergo call it as the versatile nature? These are the revision times, so I am revising you again by framing the questions. And what is the general formula of saturated hydrocarbons? Means what, which will undergo the saturated hydrocarbons? Alkane undergo the saturated hydrocarbons. What is the general formula of the alkanes? CnH2n+2. Are you clear? Next, what is the general formula for alkene and alkane? Will you write the formula for ethene? Write the formula of octane. Write the formula of hexane. Write the formula of butene. Write the formula of pentyne. See here, ene means you have to apply the general formulas of alkene, alkyne. Okay students? So this is about the revision of your beginning class, our beginning class. Today our class starts with functional groups. Today our class starts with functional groups. So what is the functional group? Functional group means, already we discussed the hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons means carbon, the compound carbon and hydrogen, we call that the hydrocarbons. To that hydrocarbon we add one atom or group of atoms. Whatever we are adding, they will completely change the characteristics of that compound. Which adding atom dominate the properties, thus we call it as the functional groups. Are you clear? Functional group means we have to add atoms or group atom or group of atoms. They will dominate the property of the compound. Thus we call it as the functional groups. Today I give the list of functional groups. Again I am revising you to our previous chapter. Coming to the periodic table. In the periodic table, we already named for the groups. For one group, what is the name? Yeah, alkali metals. 2A group, alkaline metals. 3A group, boron family. 3AR 13th group, 4AR 14th group, named as the carbon family. 5AR 15th A, sorry 15th group, nitrogen family. 6AR 16th group, sarcogen family. 7AR 17th group, same, yeah, halogens. And 8R 18th group are the noble or kinetic gases. So, functional, coming to the functional group, first functional group is the halohydrocarbons. Halohydrocarbons. Halo means belong, the elements belongs to the group of halogens. The elements belongs to the group of halogens. Those are called halohydrocarbons. So those halogens attaching to the hydrocarbon compound, those are called the halohydrocarbons. So halogens are placed in the 7th or 17th group in the period. Those are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. When bromine added to the hydrocarbon, we call it as the bromohydrocarbon. When chlorine added to the hydrocarbon, we call it as the chlorohydrocarbon. Okay, are you clear, student? This is the first functional group. Then come to the alcohols. The alcoholic group is OH. If OH group is attached to the hydrocarbon, thus we call it as the alcoholic functional group. I will give the example for the alcoholic functional group. Ethyl alcohol, methyl alcohol, ethyl, methyl, those are the hydrocarbon groups. I adding alcohol, OH means it will becomes ethyl alcohol, methyl alcohol. Okay, next functional group is aldehyde. Aldehyde means the compound CHO is attached to the hydrocarbon. The compound CHO is attached to the hydrocarbon, that we call it as the aldehyde functional group. Next, ketone functional group. C double bond O, R C double bond O attached, that we call it as the ketone group. Next, acid group, or we call it as the carboxylic acid, oic acid, those group we call it as acid group means COOH. To any hydrocarbon, we attach to COOH, that group we call it as the carboxylic group. Okay, next, esters group. Esters group means COOR is attached to hydrocarbon, that we call it as the esters group. Next, ether group. Ether group means ROR dash. Here ROR dash belongs to the alkyl groups. Are you clear? ROR dash belongs to the alkyl groups. Next, MI. NH2 is attached to the hydrocarbon. Those are called as the MI functional groups. Are you clear? This is the list of functional groups. So functional groups means which will dominate the property of the compound, that's called as the functional groups. I given the list of functional groups here, students. Again, I am revising you. These are the halohydrocarbons, means halogens. Alcoholic group means OH. Aldehyde group means CHO. Amine group means NH2. Ketone means C double bond O. Carboxylic acid means COOH. Ester group means COOR. Ether group means ROR dash. These are attached to hydrocarbon, those we call as functional groups. Okay, are you clear? These formulas you have to by head it. And these number of tests already you completed your pre final exam, already you completed your revision test 2. In all, you faced these questions in half mark and one mark. These functional formulas definitely you have to by head it, and this will come compulsory one bit in your regarding exam. Okay, student. After learning about the functional groups, now we are entering to the IUPAC. IUPAC means International Units of Pure Applied Chemistry. Whatever word, whatever the name we are keeping for the compounds, that must be accepted. That is the unique name for the compounds. Okay, before going to the IUPAC names, I want to give a small session, students. Our school management always warn you, always says that our target is not 10th. Our target is to reach into, you have to settle in even higher positions. So when after completing the 10th, you have to enter into the intermediate, you have compulsory, you have write the competitive exams or whatever entrance exams they will keep, you have to compulsory face those exams our management always suggest you, and after completing the 10th, you have to face the PolySet, you have to face the APRJC, and when you are entering into the target, reach to your target, you will choose the best college. In that best college, you have to reach to your first section, means compulsory they will test you. How they will test? They will not keep the 70% the paper they will make easy, but 30% they will give the application part. Now we are entering into our application part. By learning these names, you will identify, self-identity is very important. By learning this concept, you will identify self. Are you clearing? So this is very important. So any exam, you want to identify yourself means you have to learn. Up to you learn, now you are going to apply. Are you clearing, students? So please learn, watch this video along with book and pen with the exercise along with me. Okay, now we are entering into IUPAC names of hydrocarbons. Okay, in before class only I explained about the alkanes, alkenes, alkanes, and I explained you the series of alkanes. Series of alkanes means start with carbon is 1 means methane, 2 means ethane, 3 means propane, 4 means butane, pentane, hexane. This is the series of alkanes. How we kept meth, that is the root name. Same thing, methane, ethane, propene, sorry, methane is not there, pentane, those are the root names. So, here I given some names here, please observe here. This is, I named it as the butane, cyclobutane, 2,3-dichlorobutane. 2-chlorobut-2-ene, 3-bromo-pent-3-ine-5-ol. These are the names. You will find these names in your tonic bottles, in your syrups, or in your fibers. When you take it, you will find it. Polystyrene, polyesterene. Poly means number, ester means, I explained to you in the functional group, ester group, ene, alkene group. Are you playing? So we have to see bute is the root name and ene, it belongs to alkane. Bute means 4 carbons, ene means it belongs to the alkane group. Next, cyclo, this name divided, see, cyclo, bute, ene, this name, 2, 3 numbers, di, numeral, chloro, in the functional group I explained to you, halogen group, chloro belongs to the halogen group. Bute, root name, A. See, how many parts we combined and we named this hydrocarbon, this cycle. Here, 2-chloro-bute-2-ene, number ene. Here, 3-bromo, again it is the halogen group, pent, means 5 carbons, 3 is the number, ine means triple bond, if it is. Structure, anywhere you find the triple bond, it will become ine, alkyne group, and 5 is the number, and all is the alcoholic group. So, in that structure, number is there, halogen is added, and 5 carbons, it is belongs to the alkyne group, and one more functional group is added, that is the alcoholic group. So, how we have to name it? Means we have to follow some rules. Those rules I will say how we have to write it. After learning those rules, you will only try it, you will only exercise it, have you give some examples for it. Okay, students, now we have to learn with the IUPAC names. These are, before writing IUPAC names, see, first root. Root means already we discussed about it. It depends upon the number of carbon atom. If carbon atom is in the structure, if it is 1, meth, 2 means ith, that is the root of the structure. Next, prefix. Root before whatever we write, we call it as the prefix. Root after whatever we write, we call it as the suffix. Coming to the prefix, this prefix is again classified, again consisting of 2 parts, primary prefix, secondary prefix. Again, it will 2 parts prefix, primary prefix, secondary prefix. If the coming to the primary prefix, there is no need of number. Just seeing the structure, we have to say it. primary prefix is ni or na if the structure is linear. CH3, CH2, CH3. See the structure by seeing it is linear. By seeing like this, it is no branches, it is straight. Then we will say it, there is no need of primary prefix. Are you clear? If any branch is there like this, but also no need of primary prefix. But the structure is like this cyclic. The structure by seeing like this cyclic, then we need the primary prefix. There we have to keep cyclo. So for that no need of numbers. So the before writing the root, first we have to choose by seeing the structure. If it is linear, there is no need of writing primary prefix. If there is the branches, no need of writing anything. If the structure is like this cyclic, then only we have to keep it cyclo. So only cyclo the structure, then only primary prefix will come out. Then coming to the secondary prefix. Secondary prefix which will come is, already we informed the halogens. The group of halogens and alkyl group will come to the secondary prefix. If in the structure, see here, I attached chlorines. This chlorine we have to write before the root. Already before in structure I explained you 2-chloro-butte. Means before word root butte I added chloro. Are you clearing? So the primary which will come under the secondary prefix means halogens, halogen groups and alkyl groups, methyl, ethyl, they will come before the word. Okay, this is about the prefix. So where those halogens and where those alkyl groups will attach, for which carbon, for this carbon I attach, there I have to indicate the carbon number and how many I attach. If I attach 2 chlorines, then I have to say di. If I attach 3 chlorines, I have to say tri. Di, tri, they all come under the numeral. Are you clear? So by writing that root, before there is a prefix which will come, the prefix means the structure is cyclic, that is the primary prefix, and we have to set the branches of hydrocarbon. Other than hydrocarbon, if any halogen group is there, any alcoholic group is there, any aldehyde group attached, if alkyl group or halogens are attached, those we have to write before the word root. Are you clear? If alcohol, aldehyde means that will not come under before the word root, they won't come under the primary prefix or if secondary prefix. Only secondary prefix means halogens and alkyls. We have to attach it before the root. Are you clear? Now come to the suffix. And after writing here, see here. I already CH3, CH, CH3. Any double bond is here or single bond. So I will, how many carbons? 3 carbons. So I am writing the root name. 3 means pro and all single bonds. So yeah, alkane. That is become the suffix, primary suffix. If all the single bonds, we have to keep an. So, pro-an and all hydrocarbons, that's why you have to keep e. If it is hydrocarbon, that becomes the secondary suffix e. If not c. Next, I will keep here double bond. Between these two hydrocarbons, see students, before going to the primary suffix and secondary suffix, I written here some examples here. See here, the structure is linear. By seeing only we say there is not, it is not the cyclic, it is the linear. So there is no need of attaching the primary prefix. So we have to add any branches is there. See, all carbon and hydrogen are in this structure, all are hydrocarbons only. No halogen group, no alcoholic group, no aldehyde group is attached to this structure. So it is the linear, so no need of primary prefix. And there is no halogens and no alkyl group attached. Any halogen is there? Any alkyl group? No, it is attached. So no need of secondary prefix. So directly we have to go through the word root. What is the word root means? First we have to count the carbon atoms. How many carbons? 1, 2, 3. So what is the word root? Pro. Okay. Then after we have to go to suffix. After writing word root, then we have to see if any double bond is there, any triple bond is there. No. So all single bonds. So all single bonds means it belongs to the alkane. Alkane means we have to write attached AL. Okay. Then we have to pass to the secondary suffix. Secondary suffix. If it is all hydrocarbons, we have to attach only. See, only hydrocarbons. So I am attaching here E. If any alcoholic group, we have to attach OL. If any aldehyde group, we have attached AN. Ketone means ONE1. Acid group means I. We have to add butanoic acid. Okay, if any acid group added, we have to read it butanoic acid. Like that. So, by exciting, we have to learn it. Are you clear here? See, in this structure, there is no primary prefix, no secondary prefix. That's why you directly went to the word root. Then, first, primary suffix. Primary suffix means we have to see single bond, double bond, triple bond. No single bond, no triple bond, only single bond. That's why I attached AN. Then after, any functional groups are there? No, any functional groups are not attached. It is only hydrocarbon. That's why I attach E. So in this name, there are the three parts. This is the word root. This is the AN is the primary suffix. E is the secondary suffix. Are you clear? So word root, primary, this in this name only three parts is there. Next, coming to this structure. So primary suffix means, are you clear? Only alkane, alkene, alkyne. Alkane means we have to add AN after word root. If alkene means we have to add EN after the word root. Alkyne means we have to add YNI. Okay. If I then after adding the alkane, alkene primary suffix, then we have to pass to the secondary suffix. Coming to the secondary suffix, it will comes under the secondary suffix means hydrocarbons, alcoholic group, aldehyde group, ketone group, amine group, ether group, ester groups. These all come under the secondary suffixes. Okay. Now come to this structure. First, how many carbons? That's why I'm giving the numbering. See here, how many carbons are there? Only two carbons. One. Okay. And the structure is linear. No, there is a branch and one more functional group is also added. See, here one, two branches are there. Coming. So the circular, it is branch. It is not cyclic, so no need of primary prefix. So there is a branch. See, the branch is any alkane, halogen group is there? Yeah. Chlorine belongs to the halogen. So it comes under the secondary prefix. Yeah. So this we have to attach. This chlorine, where it is there, in which carbon it is attached? In second carbon here. See, and one more thing you have to remember here, where the branch in the structure, where the branch is there, that branch have the least number. So I want, so we have to give the number from here upwards. The branch will get the least number. So 1, 2. Where the branch is attached? At 1. So 1. What is the halogen? Chloro. I am writing the name here. 1 is the number. Only 1. So no need of numeral. If 2, the number is 1. More than 1, we have to say it di. So here only 1. At 1 carbon it is attached. So 1. Chloro, the halogen. This is the number. This is the secondary prefix. Now, count the carbons. How many? 2. 1, 1, 2. So, what is the root name? Git. 1, chloro, git. Okay. So, word root completed. After completing the word root, what you have to choose the? It is the single bond, double bond, triple bond. See, any single double bond? Any? No. So, directly all single bonds. That's why. What is the primary suffix? It will come under the alkane is AN. Then after primary suffix also completed. Now come to the secondary suffix. Secondary suffix, see, one more functional group is added. Which group? OH belongs to which functional group? Alcoholic group. It comes under the secondary group. If alcohol is added, where this alcohol is added? Again it is added to at the first carbon it is added to this alcoholic group. So, if alcoholic group is added, what we have to keep it? OL. If alcoholic group can be added, this we have to write it OL. Aldehyde means AL. So, OF. The name of the structure is 1-chloroethane-1-ol. Are you clear? 1-chloroethane-1-ol. While writing the IUPAC names, so first we have to find the structure. First we have to see, while writing we have to follow the 11 rules. First where we have to write, that is the root, that the number given for it 5. Before root whatever we write we call it the prefix. After root whatever we write we is called it the suffix. Before root there are primary prefix, number, numeral, secondary prefix. Then after root, number, numeral, primary suffix, number, numeral, secondary suffix. So primary suffix, by seeing the structure we have to say only cyclic means there is a need of primary prefix. And coming to the secondary prefix, which secondary prefix means which will come before the root means those are the halogen groups and alkyl groups. Then after the root writing, word root, then after those whatever we write we call it the suffix. Again the suffix is primary suffix and secondary suffix. Coming to the primary suffix, with the hydrocarbons are alkanes, alkenes, alkynes, that will come under the primary suffix. And if the any functional groups like alcohol, aldehyde, ketone, oic acid, amyl groups will added, those will come under the secondary suffix. Okay, now we are going to exercise. See, I give it here one. This is the first structure. CH3, CH, CH, CH3. Each carbon bonded with the C. This carbon bonded with 3 hydrogen atoms and 1 single bond. This carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 bonds. This carbon 1, 2, 3, 4. This carbon 1 with 3 hydrogens. Okay, now we have to write the name. See here, this is linear, no branches here. So there is, so no, it is not cyclic, it is only linear. That's why no need of primary prefix. Then after, we have to directly go to the word, sorry, secondary prefix. Secondary prefix when we come means, if any halogen group or any alkyl group added, then only secondary prefix will come. Here any halogen group is there? Any alkyl group is there? No. So we have to go directly to the word root. So how we will write the word root means, we will count the carbon atoms. Here count the carbon atoms, give the number to carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 carbons means the root is, word root is but. Okay. So after writing word root, then whatever we write, we'll call it as the suffixes. Next we have to go to the primary suffix. Primary suffix means hydrocarbons. Alkane, alkene, alkane. Here any triple bond is there? No. Any double bond is there? Yeah, double bond is here. Okay. See where the double bond is here? At the second carbon, the double bond is here. Are you clearing? At the second carbon, so that's why the number, which carbon? Which carbon? The alkene or alkene is added, have secondary, primary suffix added, that number we have to indicate. So here at the second carbon, E group added. So that's why at the number 2, only 1, so no need of numeral. Then what is here? Double bond. Double bond means alkene. Alkene means what? How to write it? Yeah. But it is attached to second carbon, that is ene. Then after, what we have to do it then? We have to find the secondary suffix. Secondary suffix means alcoholic groups. Any alcohol, sorry, secondary suffix means functional groups. Any functional groups are added here? No. No alkali group, no aldehyde, no ketone. So this is completely hydrocarbon, that's why E. See, but2ene. This is the word, this is the number of the primary suffix, this is the primary suffix, and this is the secondary suffix. Are you clear? But2ene. The name of this structure is but2ene. Next, come to this structure. CH3, CH, CH2, CH3, and two branches are there. By seeing that the branches, it is not cyclic. So no need of primary prefix. So then after the branches, what are they attached to hydrocarbons? First find it. Bromine, chlorine, these two are added. These two all come under the halogen group. Bromine will come under the halogen group. Chlorine will come to the halogen group. So where we did will come under the secondary prefix. So secondary prefix, before writing secondary prefix, we have to give the number to the carbon atoms. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. Wherever I am branching, but the branch will get the least number. Like this also, 1, 2, 3, 4 or 1, 2. So the branch will get 2, 3, 2, 3. Okay. So I am writing here from, I started and giving number from this side. This side onwards, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there is no primary prefix. So I am going to writing the secondary prefix. Before writing secondary prefix, where that prefix is added, at what carbon it is added? At second carbon and third carbon. Both are same? No, both are not same. So that's why 2, the number, only 1. So no need of numeral. 2, bromo, it is the bromine. And one more halogen is added. That also we have to, halogen means we have to write before the word root. So chlorine is the halogen group. So where it is attached? At the third carbon. 2, bromo, 3, chloro. 2 bromo, 3 chloro. So this is the secondary prefix. The number where it is attached and which halogen is attached. 2 bromo, 3 chloro. Okay. Next, directly go to the word root. What is the, how many carbons here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So what is the root name? Bute. If the carbons are 4 means the root name is the 4. Then after C. After writing word root, we have to go to the suffix. Primary suffix means any double bond, triple bond. Any double bond is here? No. Any triple bond? No. So directly we see all it is the hydrocarbon. So I kept keeping here alkane group, It belongs to the alkane, that's why And no oxygen groups, all are the hydrocarbons. So 2 bromo, 3 chloro, butane. So 2 is the number, bromo is the halogen. 3 is the number, chloro is the halogen, bute is the word root, and becomes the alkane group, E becomes the hydrocarbon. So like this we have to name this structure, 2 bromo 3 chloro butane E. Like this they will keep the names. Okay, now third structure. See, this is the linear, this is not the cyclic, so that's why no need of primary prefix. And any branches are there? No. Any halogen group is there? No. Any alkyl group is attached? No. So directly go to word root. How many carbons? 1, 2, 3. I am giving the numbers. See here, triple bond is started here. So I am giving number here. 1, 2, 3. So how many carbons? 1, 2, 3. Directly I am going to the word root. 3 carbons means pro. Then we have to go to primary suffix. Any triple bond is there? Triple bond. From which carbon the triple bond is attached? From first carbon. So 1, if the triple bond means alkyne. Alkyne means we have the add I. Okay. Any functional group is attached to this structure? No. So it is completely hydrocarbon. That's why E. Pro 1 I. This is the secondary suffix. This is the I in the primary suffix. I is the number, 1 is the number of the primary suffix. Okay, pro 1 I is the name of this structure. Will you try this structure? See students, here it is also linear, no need of primary prefix. So going to this structure, there is no halogens, no alkyl groups. So that's why I will give the number for the carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But here see functional group attached here, that's why it will, the number have to come, the, it will, for this, the number have to come least. So the number not from here onwards, the number we have to give. So 5 carbons, I am going direct to the word root. So 5 carbons means pent or clearing. And then primary suffix. Any double bond is there? Any triple bond? So there is no double bond, no triple bond. So there is no primary. Primary suffix is there, that is the alkane, all single bonds. So the primary suffix is the alkane. Alkane means AN. Okay, then after we have to go to the secondary suffix. Secondary suffix, see any alcoholic group, aldehyde group. Here we are finding the acid group. This is the acid functional group. So for acid functional group, where it is attached? At 2. So 2 number I am giving that 2 per acid which I carboxylic acid. So we have to indicate oic. Pentane 2 oic. Oic acid, sir. The name of the structure is pentane 2 oic acid. Like this we have to do. In your textbook there is more structures are there. Please try to name it and practice it. This is following the rules of primary prefix, secondary prefix and primary suffix and secondary suffix. Two more examples I want to explain you. See here, this is one structure and this is another structure. Coming to this structure, now we have to name it. See, by seeing the structure, it is linear. Branches, your branches is there, but it is cyclic. So cyclic means there is the primary prefix. So we have to write it cyclo. The structure name first we have to start with cyclo. Okay. Then after, for this cycle, any branches are there? Yeah, branches, two branches. See that branch, halogen group is there? Yeah, halogen group is there. So it will come to the secondary prefix. So we have to write the secondary prefix. Before writing secondary prefix, we have to give the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4. For the carbons, I am giving the number C. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the secondary prefix added at 1. So cyclo 1, what is the halogen chlorine? Cyclo 1, chloro. Okay. Now come to the word root. How many carbons? 4 carbons. So, you. Then after we have to pass to the suffix. After writing word root suffix, first we have to see double bond, single, triple bond and single bond. Any triple bond is there? No. Double bond? Yeah, here. At 1, 2, we have finding the double bond. So, where we are finding the double bond? At 2. So, 2. Double bond, triple bond, after word root we have to add it. So, at carbon 2, the double bond is there. So, I am giving the number 2. And for the double bond means it belongs to alkene group, means we have to add E. Okay. Then after we have to go to secondary suffix. Secondary suffix means alcohol, aldehyde. Like that we have to see it. See here? Yeah, alcoholic group we are finding here. From where which carbon it is added? For third carbon it is added. So we have to keep the number 3. For alcoholic group, what you have to keep? Ol. So cyclo 1, chloro, but 2, e, 3, R. That is the name of this structure. Are you clearing? Cyclo, the structure is cyclic. And halogen group is added. Wait, for where it is added? The halogen chlorine added at first carbon. Then after, but means it in the structure 4 carbons are there and it is the belongs to that but belongs to which group? Alkene group. Where that alkene group? At second carbon E group is added. Then after functional group is added. What is the functional group? Alcohol. Where it is added? At third carbon, that is the 3R. So completely the structure and name is cyclo 1 chloro but 2 E 3R. You read the alkene, you read the functional names, yes sir, no? You know the halogens, you know the alkyl groups, all compare, how we have to write the name, like this you have to apply it by doing the exercise. Okay, now we will try it. This is the structure, it is not the cyclic, it is only linear, so no need of primary prefix. So there is a branch, so I want to give the numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4. Branch will get the least number. By giving number like this, 1, 2, branch will get third number. That's why I am giving the number from this side onwards to get the least number to the branch. So, the branch is there. The branch is the halogen group. So, before what we have to add it? For which carbon it is added? For the second carbon it is added. So, 2, chloro. How many carbons? 4 carbons, but, word root, and now we have to see that triple bond. First of all, triple bond is there? Yeah. Where it is there? At 4th carbon. So, 4 triple bond is there, that's why I. Then after, see, completed, double bond is also there. Where it is? At number 2nd carbon. So, 2, E, no functional groups. So all hydrocarbons here. 2 chloro but 4 I 2 ene. This is the structure name. Are you clear? 2 chloro but 4 I 2 ene. These all names you will find in any fertilizers or any tonics. You will find it in detergent. Okay, so you have to imagine the this much of hydrocarbons functional groups, all you learn it, those when you apply it on writing the names, then only you get the IUPAC names. Are you clear, student? Please try to do exercise in your textbook and in your book. So many examples are there. Try to your own and apply it. Are you clear? Have a nice day. Thank you.
Ullampur Montessori School గత నెల రోజుల నుంచి ఆన్లైన్ క్లాసులు చాలా సమర్థవంతంగా నిర్వహిస్తుంది. రాబోయే రోజుల్లో ఇలాంటి ఇబ్బంది ఎప్పుడొచ్చినా కూడా ఆన్లైన్ టూల్స్తో విద్యాబోధన సమర్థవంతంగా చేసే విద్యా సంస్థ మన ఉల్లంపూర్ మాంటెసోరి స్కూల్. అందుకే ఉల్లంపూర్ మాంటెసోరి స్కూల్ అంటే తల్లిదండ్రులకు ఓ నమ్మకం, ఓ భరోసా.
మాంటెసోరి స్కూల్ మారుతున్న కాలానికి తగ్గట్టుగా వసతులు పెంచుకుంటూ నూతన విద్యా విధానానికి అనుగుణంగా అధునాతన టెక్నాలజీ ఏర్పాటు చేసుకుంటూ అత్యుత్తమ విద్యా సంస్థగా ఎదిగింది. ఉల్లంపరు మాంటెసోరి అంటే చదువులో నెంబర్ 1, ఆటలలో నెంబర్ 1, సాంస్కృతిక కార్యక్రమాలలో నెంబర్ 1.
విద్యార్థి ఆల్రౌండ్ డెవలప్మెంట్ కు చిరునామా ఉల్లంపరు మాంటెసోరి స్కూల్,
ద లీడర్ ఇన్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్.